It's that time of year again. Rescroll through our phone, delete those contacts, delete those messages, and set our goals for the upcoming year. But how many of us actually stick to those goals? So I want to create the ultimate 2023 preparation guide. So if you're ready to transform your 2023, keep watching.
What's going on, guys? It's Juliana. Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys the process of how I get ready for the new year. So right now it is 9:27.
What?
December 31st. So New Year's is less than a few hours away. And so I started a little late, but this is how I prepare for the new year. So I want to start this video off by recapping my 2022. This year has been, it wasn't horrible. This year was not a horrible year. It wasn't good and it wasn't bad. It was okay. A lot of stuff I could accomplish this year. I graduated high school, got into college, started college, made a lot of friends, had a pretty good first semester, tried new food, traveled. But one of the biggest things is I got back on YouTube. I remained pretty consistent and was able to create like a little supporter fan base for myself, so I'm very thankful for that. Definitely recommend anyone to reflect on their year just so you can see like your highs and lows and pinpoint like any consistent behaviors, any patterns that you don't want to take into 2023. Being able to look back on your goals kind of like motivates you to be like, okay, if I was able to accomplish this, who knows what I can accomplish. And so that's why I would definitely recommend everybody just sit down and reflect on your year. Like, look at the good things, look at the bad things. Don't just highlight the good things and just highlight the bad things. So with all that being said, I hope you guys go into the new year remembering that you're in control of the year. You're in control of what you want to accomplish this year. You're in control of what you want to accomplish in the new year, the person you want to become. Also, this is more of like a chill sit down video. As you can see, I'm pretty comfortable, not wearing anything. Because this is more just chill and just relaxation. So the next thing that I like to do is set goals. So I'm going to open my notes app and go through my goals for you guys. And you can write your goals down. I do plan on writing mine down, but at the moment I don't have a journal. Put your goals in different categories. So there's friends, there's travel, there's finance, there's personal, social, stuff like that. So I'm not gonna go in too depth of like what each of my goals are for the new year, but a few that I want to highlight is definitely social media wise. I do want to be more consistent on YouTube. I want to post a lot more on Instagram and actually optimize my content. I want to be able to travel a lot more, visit new places. I want to meet new people. I want to try new food. I want to pick up different skills. And I just want to open up any like projects that I left unfinished for 2023. So goal setting is really a good thing to do, especially starting early on. You don't have to do goals for the entire year. What I like to do is set goals for each month. So for January, my goal is, let's say 500 subscribers on YouTube. Hitting 10,000 followers on Instagram, saving up a certain amount of money, accomplishing certain goals, going to the gym, stuff like that. So just setting goals for each month so that you can kind of like force yourself to accomplish them, because you know you're on a deadline, and you can reward yourself for reaching those goals too. So it's like, okay, if I reach 500 subscribers by the end of January, I will take myself out to dinner or something like that. So you have a goal that you're working towards. Another one of my personal goals is to definitely focus on self-care in 2023. I just recently started picking up on self-care towards the end of 2022, just because I spent a lot of time focusing on the next person, worrying about like what other people thought, how other people were doing, and putting other people's emotions before myself. So my goal for 2023 is to definitely focus on me, practice self-care, spend a lot of time with God, journal, get enough hours of sleep, and just spend time with myself and treat myself, give myself the love that I'm always trying to give to somebody else. So self-care is definitely a big thing on my list for 2023. Definitely having self-care days, maintenance days, nails, or just treating myself. So I want to work on just not being so vocal about everything, because my biggest issue is I love to talk. Whenever something happens, I'm quick to go tell other people. So my biggest goal that I'm trying to like set in stone is to just not speak so much and just journal it and let it go, especially like if it's a personal issue, an issue that I dealt with, a friendship that didn't work out, relationship that didn't work out. I'm trying to teach myself just to say it didn't work out and keep it going, and not having to like sit down and tell them my entire life story, because people don't deserve your entire life story. And that's how you block your blessings, by talking so much. So stop telling my plans, stop telling people my life story, just learning how to just hush. So I went to Walmart and bought this big picture frame. This is what I'm going to put my vision board in, just so I can hang it up and put it in my dorm. So now I'm gonna open up my laptop and show you guys how I make my vision board. Baby, where did these niggas be at when they say they doing all this and all that? Okay, so I finished the vision board that's gonna be going on my laptop. So I'm just gonna save this and put it as my background. So as far for the vision board that's physical, I'm gonna save all these pictures and go ahead and print them out and put them in my vision board. Okay, hey guys, I'm back from printing. It took about like 30 minutes to an hour. I printed a good amount of things to put on my vision board. So let me show you guys again what we're working with. So this is what I have. It's pretty big. And now that I'm looking, I think I probably printed out a lot more than needed. And it's kind of, a lot of these are pretty big, so a lot of them probably won't fit in there. But that is okay, because I can always buy a new one, or I could just print smaller ones. So I'm gonna start working on this and set a little time lapse so you guys can see me as I work on my vision board. Hey guys, so I just got finished with my vision board. I ended up making two. I'm actually just gonna show one of them, because the other one's more personal. So this one ended up being the one that ended up making extra, because I had too many pictures, and I remember that I had an extra photo frame. So on here, I'm just gonna show you guys the different things that I have on here. So this right here is just motivation to put more effort in outfits and put better outfits together. Here's because I want to travel more and visit new countries. This one's for working out more. This is just because Dear is such a big inspiration to me. Down here is YouTube. I want to be hit 10,000 subscribers. Up here is just something I want to work on, is learning to do lashes. This is business inspiration for my business that I want to start. This is because I want to get my own apartment. I want to strengthen my relationship with God. I want to go out with friends more and make new friends. This is just Black Girl Luxury and just another travel one. As we're winding down this video, the final topic I want to talk about is just acting as your higher self. So the person you want to become, you need to start putting the effort into that person. You can't just make a dream board, you can't write down your goals and not put any action towards it. So that means working out, that means doing your, if you want to get higher grades, doing your assignments, that means you want clear skin, going to dermatologists. Just working towards your goals is how you're going to achieve them, because you can't just put stuff in the universe without any type of work. So that means like starting January 1st, start acting like the person you want to be. You want to have 1,000 YouTube, if you want to have 1,000 subscribers, start acting like you have 1,000 subscribers. Put out content, post regularly the content that you know that would drive people. And of course, just putting yourself first and just treating you, because when you look good, you feel good. When you feel good, you do good. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys have a great 2023. And I'm just can't wait to see everything that we're all gonna accomplish, because I truly believe that 2023 is gonna be a great year. So if you guys enjoyed this video, if you did, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And I cannot wait to see you guys in my next video. Bye.